wasn't ready. You weren't, but Sir Hurlalot sure was.
Cool. What else is it, girl?
Hockey pucks, baseballs.
It's supposed to help you practice sports, okay? It obviously doesn't take any consideration that my game needs help to begin with. I'm gonna take a ping pong.
So, what does your robot do?
Well, nothing yet. Josie is supposed to wake up early this morning to finish the steering mechanism, but something tells me she overslept again. This is all it does.
Not bad. If you want to make a milkshake.
Hey, you should let us work on it. Add a saw blade and body armor?
Yeah. We could fix ours up and put a jackhammer on it.
And rename it Pounder?
Then put those two in a ring and you've got some serious carnage.
Typical guys, always talking about destruction.
Well, you know, at least they're thinking about their project, which is, you know, more than my late, disorganized, and, oh yeah, messy partner.
No need to freak on me. Look, our robot only needs a couple of tweaks. It'll be ready in a sec. See? I figured out what was wrong with it last night while I was sleeping.
Don't be the stairs! Maybe you should have tweaked for another second.
Blake Holsey High. Just another boarding school. So I thought, but things are a little different here. I've made some friends. Even got a cool teacher. The principal is definitely hiding something. And this guy, Victor Pearson. Somehow he's beyond all the really weird stuff that happens here. We'll figure it out. But in the meantime, these are strange days at Blake Holsey High.
Nice work, Joe. Now it matches your side of the room.
It's a simple malfunction. I'll deal with it.
And how exactly are you going to deal with it?
The same way she deals with pizza crust. She just feeds them to the couch.
Or old magazines. She builds the world's tallest freestanding stack.
Or, like laundry, just lets it self-combust.
Or
enough. No more oars.
Come on, Josie, we're just having a little fun.
Oh, fun? Oh, you know what would be fun? Wrapping you in this and smothering you guys in this. Now that would be funny. I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make this robot better than ever. I'll show you.
An observer?
Well, why would they send an observer to Blake Holsey? What are they supposed to be observing?
I don't know, it doesn't say.
Well, I'm sure it's nothing.
I don't like it. One of these I'm sure it's nothing observers closed our sister school last year. Sanitation issues. Oh, very ugly. We have to get this place in tip-top shape. Blake Holsey has to be perfect. We can start with your office, Professor Zachary. It always looks like a hurricane hit it in there.
Josie? I'm not shishing. I lent you my CD.
And I returned it.
Right. And now it's covered in nacho cheese sauce.
Sorry. Look.
Wow.
Well, I was right. It's even got a sensing eye for directional purposes. Just wait till you see her in action.
Are these your plans?
Yeah, they kind of evolved as I went. Just wait till you see how well it works. It's gonna make order out of chaos.
There's actually a floor under your stuff. Where are you gonna sleep?
I got a whole half bed. There's plenty of room.
And how are you gonna find stuff? It's still disorganized.
I don't get you.
Well, what if you wanted a CD? Let's say one without nacho sauce.
Like this? Look, I know where things are. Just because I don't organize things alphabetically and color-code with little sticky notes, like someone I know, doesn't mean I'm hopeless.
What about your hairbrush? Science book? Maybe this will work out after all. Good job, Jose.
And you too, Robo Josie. You just saved a friendship.
Hey, I was eating that.
You were finished. Oh, sloppy Joes. Why today? When everything needs to be so neat.
Miss Durst. The name's Gonfort R. Pemmican, and I'm here to make a full report on this institution.
Oh, yes. We were expecting you. Mr. Pemmington, what exactly are you here to inspect?
Well, right now, I'd like to inspect lunch.
Certainly. I'll see what our head chef has on the menu.
Scrape the meat off two sloppy joes, warm up yesterday's spaghetti, mix the two together and bring it out on a nice plate. And do something creative with that awful apple pie.
How does spaghetti bolognese sound?
And just this once, wear your hairnet.
Nicely done, Josie. You deserve a well-earned nap. And you need a little improvement to your electronics.
How about some coffee?
Thank you.
Now, Mr. Pemmican, I'm sure a man of your sophistication would agree that your dining experience has been superior. Dare I say, 5-star?
I couldn't agree more.
Oh. You're not writing anything down.
What? Oh, no. This is for my observations.
Speaking of which, I better get started.
But the food quality, the immaculate kitchen.
It's very good. But immaterial.
Wow. This is incredible.
Don't thank me. Thank Robo Josie.
Whoa. It's clean. What have you done with Josie?
Very funny.
Hey, you left your book in class.
Wow. It's actually making decisions, like where to put stuff.
Wild, huh? I found these killer electronics in the basement and added a few tweaks of my own.
So now that you're a neat freak, what do we have to complain about?
Good one, Lucas.
That is so cool.
Problem with the programming. I'll reboot it. It'll be fine.
Josie, get away from me.
It's not turning on.
The batteries must be dead. I bet Lucas has some.
Shut it off.
I did.
Well, it's obviously got some wires crossed or something. We better cut its power.
Just snip the wires from the batteries to the motors.
Got it.
Thanks, guys. She's good. No way.
Josie, where's it going?
Not from the health department at all. And I wasted spaghetti bolognese on him.
We have spaghetti bolognese? Sorry. Well, what do you think
he's measuring a banister? He's the safety inspector.
Excuse me. Have these cracks always been here?
Oh my, yes. They are historic cracks.
Made by monks in the early
19th century.
How odd.
It's an odd place. A very safe odd place.
Very safe.
I assure you, this is a very, very safe place.
Historic cracks? Who's the guy you're trying to snow?
Safety inspector. Which reminds me, you're not planning anything destructive, right?
Me? On a totally unrelated topic, if you see a robot go by, let me know.
Josie!
Because your robot's exactly like you.
Oh, come on, I'm not that bad.
Hello? Hello? Aha, there you are. Chaos theory. Why read about it when the school's living it?
I like to read.
But it was dark.
Your eyes adjust.
Oh, yeah, yes. Well, read on your own time. Right now, the school needs to be gone over with a fine-tooth comb. Pick out the tiniest safety infraction and fix it immediately. Work into the night if you have to. Apparently, you enjoy the dark.
Okay, where's that manual? I know I left it here somewhere. My new CD. Starting to see how Curran feels. Maybe this robot is too much like me.
Josie, your robot's out of control.
I can see that. I didn't program it to do this. You've got to believe me.
Oh, we believe you. That robot's gone crazy. I mean, it's totally random and messy. Just like you.
Josie's not random and messy.
Of course I am. That's all you ever talk about?
No, you're not. I mean, yeah, your side of the room looks like it's random and messy and doesn't really make sense to me, but you do know where everything is. Like that CD you pulled from the pile. It's like organized chaos.
Wait a minute, that's it. Chaos theory. Remember we talked about it in the science club?
Right. What's that again?
It says that chaotic systems may appear to be disorderly, even random, but they're not. Underneath them, there's a sense of order, a pattern. It's just hard to see.
Unless you're a mathematician with a powerful computer.
Or a chaotic system yourself.
Okay, thanks for that moment in the spotlight, but I don't destroy things.
No, you don't. Wait, did you do anything different to the robot after you programmed it?
No, nothing.
No, you did. You rebooted after it tore up my paper. Oh, yeah, Professor Z, my paper's gonna be late.
That's all right, Corinne. Something changed when you rebooted. I bet it defaulted to an extreme version of you.
So maybe you can figure out the robot's pattern and predict what it'll do next. You are the one with the most experience thinking chaotically.
Yeah. Josie, if you were running amok, what would you do next?
Well, let's see. If I graffitied and TP'd the halls, squirted ketchup at people, and threw pies, I guess I'd want some music to go with the carnage. PA system! Then what would you do? I guess I'd mess with Durst and that inspector.
We have to find them. I'll check the teacher's lounge.
Marshall, Lucas, I'm about to make your dreams come true. Look, the only way to stop my robot is to get yours after it. After we modify it into...
Pounder! What in the name of all things holy is going on?
I think it was made by one of the students. Wonderful engineering, don't you think?
I think it's appalling that the principal of a school would allow such a thing.
But look at the craftsmanship. The aim.
This is an abomination.
I assure you, this is very unusual. But I will find out who is responsible. Sorry.
Look who's come to play.
It's letting them go.
Yeah, that's part of my pattern. I'd never back away from a fight, and neither would Robo Jesse.
I split in two. Why'd it do that?
See, I approach things like it's a game. But I know when to stop. The extreme version of me didn't. So she played the game to the end.
This school is beyond chaos.
I know. Isn't it great?
Hey, it looks good in here.
Well, it's a start.
Do you like the way I artfully arranged my dirty socks? And am I looking at a mold-free zone?
Yeah, well, I guess you had a small but important point about my being a total slob, so I decided to put in an effort. Being me is one thing, but being me all over you, well, that's not really fair.
Well, I think you had a small but important point about my being a total crank, so I'll try not to yell at you so much about your chaotic way of doing things. As long as you promise you'll never build another robot again.
Deal.
Deal.
Hey, I wonder what that guy was inspecting anyway.
The most intriguing findings, if you'll turn to page 12, were the extremely strong magnetic fields and the unexplained gravitational pull in the area of Professor Zachary's office and in the basement around the janitor's residence.
Janitor's residence? Why would that be?
Inconclusive.
Interesting. What else did you observe about this janitor?